Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Now there are two concepts basically, proposal and acceptance. These two concepts, they are very essential for the formation of contract. So in this video we'll see what is acceptance and what are the essentials of acceptance. This is Dr. Bansode and I welcome to you all on my channel. So let's begin with the video. So as per section 2B of the Indian Contract Act, when the person to whom the proposal is made signifies his assent thereto, the proposal is said to be accepted. So the person who made the proposal to the acceptor, and to that effect acceptor is giving consent or assent to that proposal, then we are saying ki proposal is accepted. Once the proposal accepted, it becomes a promise. And whenever there is a promise, then there is a concluded contract between the parties. And so this is the very notion what we understand from section 2B when we understand the definition of acceptance. Now what are the essentials of acceptance? So first essential, the acceptance must be absolute and unconditional. Now when we say acceptance must be absolute and unconditional, it means that absolute and unconditional acceptance of all the terms of the proposal has the effect of converting the proposal into a promise. So when Hyde versus Rinch, this is a landmark case, a landmark judgment, in which A offered to B his farm for £1,000, and B said he would buy it for £950. Now this was refused by A, and A refused to sell that farm for £950 to B. And then B again expressed his willingness to buy for £1,000. A again refused, and so B filed a suit in the court of law against A. In this case, court understood that when B signifies his intention to accept the farm for £950, he actually made a counter offer to A. And since the acceptance cannot be recognized in this manner because it should be absolute and unconditional, but here in this case B is actually not accepted the proposal in an absolute and unconditional manner, but he is actually given a counter offer to A, and so this is considered as a conditional acceptance. And hence conditional acceptance is no acceptance as per the Indian Contract Act. And so the court held that there is no contract between the parties. Second essential when we say, that is the mode of acceptance. Now when the proposal prescribes the manner, mode or method of acceptance, the acceptance must be made in that manner or in that mode or in that method only. If it is not made in the prescribed manner, then the promisor may insist that his proposal shall be accepted in the same manner as he prescribed. If proposal is silent in regards with the mode, manner of acceptance, then the acceptance must be in some reasonable manner. That is what provided under section 7 of the Indian Contract Act. Now in regards with this point, 1819, in that year Eliasson versus Henshaw, that was case decided, and in this case A offered to buy floor from B, informing B that he should send acceptance by wagon bringing the offer. Now B, having decided to accept the offer, sent his acceptance by post, under the impression that the acceptance by post would reach A faster. But unfortunately, the letter of acceptance reached A after the arrival of the wagon. And so in this case also, court held that A was not bound by the acceptance, because the B's acceptance is not in the manner, in the mode as indicated by A. And so if offer prescribe a mode or the manner of acceptance, it should be made in that mode or in that manner only. Now third essential, which talks about the mental acceptance. Now mental acceptance is no acceptance unless accompanied by an overt act. And so mental acceptance, until and unless that mental acceptance is not coupled with the overt act, it cannot be a valid acceptance. Now in this also, Feldhaus versus Binley, a very well known judgment which was decided in 1863. In this, Feldhaus offer by letter to buy his nephew's horse, the horse name is Zed, for £30, saying that if I hear no more about him, I shall consider the horse mine at £30. Now nephew did not reply, but instructed the auctioneer, who was actually selling the horse or horses, that nephew instructed to the auctioneer that the horse not to sell to the Z. Now the auctioneer inadvertently sold Z to D. Feldhaus filed a case against the auctioneer, and in this case it was held that Feldhaus had no claim against the auctioneer, as there was no concluded contract between Feldhaus and that nephew N. And so Feldhaus offer of £30 was not accepted by that nephew itself. And so जहाँ तक mental acceptance की बात हम करते हैं, so mental acceptance is no acceptance unless it is accompanied by some overt act. So nephew didn't reply anything, and to that effect, if Feldhaus is considering that he is accepting his offer, then that is a wrong, and that cannot be considered as a valid acceptance on the part of that ain. So some overt act, some expression needs to be there along with the mental acceptance. Next, that is, the offer must be expressed, or it can be implied also. So acceptance may be expressed, that is oral or written, or implied from the conduct of the promisee. Judgment was decided in 1893. And in this case, the defendant company advertised that any person who would attack with influenza after using a specific medicine, that is carbolic smoke ball, which was introduced by the company, then the company would be paid £100 as a compensation. And to that effect, company also stated that it had already deposited £1,000 with one bank to show their sincerity in the matter. Now the plaintiff, that is Carlyle, after using the smoke ball as directed by the company, caught influenza, and so she filed a suit in the court of law. And in this case, the court of appeal affirming the judgment of the lower court held that company is liable to pay the plaintiff £100. Now interestingly, the company raised the contention in this case that Carlyle ought to have notified her acceptance to the company, but court rejected this contention of the company because the offer by the company was accepted by performing the condition attached to the proposal. So when you are prescribing a condition, and accordingly the Carlyle taken that medicine, so that amounts to the implied acceptance of the Carlyle. And so the acceptance may be expressed, that is oral or written, and at the same time the acceptance can be implied also, that is from the conduct of the parties or from the conduct of the promisee also, it can be conveyed to the promisor. And so that is the essential of the acceptance. Next is the acceptance of all the terms must be there. So an act done in ignorance of the proposal is no acceptance. So whenever the person, that is the acceptor, is giving acceptance, he has to know what is proposal. So but where an offer is accepted, it amounts to acceptance of all its terms, even if the offeree is ignorant of some of the terms of the offer. But still we can say that the offer is accepted by that acceptor. So when we say this particular acceptance of all the terms, Parker versus South Eastern Rail Company, 1877, in that year this case was decided. In that, a ticket on the face of it was written that subject to condition what mentioned on the other side. So whenever we are traveling, we are getting the ticket. Whenever we are traveling through train, we are getting the ticket. And in that also we could understand there is a indicators PTO, turnover. And so it is a responsibility of the passenger to read at the backside what conditions they have mentioned or they have written. In this case also, on the ticket it was indicated that some conditions mentioned on the other side of that ticket. And so when plaintiff challenged the ticket or the contract, court held that the plaintiff was bound by the conditions even though he did not read them. But this rule have certain exceptions. Number one, the terms are not apparent on the face of the document. It means that there is no such expression on the face of the document which indicates those conditions. Yeah, on the face of the document, the conditions, they cannot be in a reasonable manner can appear or can see, then this rule cannot be accepted, or this rule or this acceptance cannot be binding on the promisee. At the same time, on the ticket or on such document, in a very small letter, it is indicated that CBAC or PTO or turnover, which a reasonable man cannot trace out on the face of that ticket. And so there is no such reasonable care has been taken to invite the attention of the acceptor. So in such particular circumstances, the acceptor cannot be bound by that particular acceptance. So these are the two exceptions to this particular rule, that is acceptance, consider as a acceptance of all terms. So these are the basic essentials. So here we are ending with this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon and do watch the further videos what I am going to upload. Thank you very much. Thank you.